Hello, Mr. Ramos. We removed the engine air filters from your car and we have them here on the floor, and I just wanted to show you that these air filters are extremely dirty, and you can see there's a lot of dirt coming out of them, and these filters get replaced or should be replaced every 15,000 miles, and as you can see they're extremely dirty. These filters should look like this if they're in good shape, and they are not in good shape, so I'm recommending that you change your engine air filters. The next thing I'm recommending that you should do at this service interval is change your AC dust filter. Your AC dust filter is dirty, and this is what a dirty one looks like, and a new one looks like this. So this is a new air AC dust filter, and as you can see with this old one, it does have some dirt, and this filter filters out all the incoming air from the outside, and if you don't change it, you'll be breathing dirty air. So we should change this, both the air filters and dust filter, at this time. The next thing we're going to show you is that the brake fluid is starting to get dirty, and it should be a transparent yellow color, and it's not. It's a dark brown color, and we suggest that you flush your brake fluid system, and we're going to bleed the brakes if we get your okay. Brake fluid typically should be replaced every 2 years, and it looks like it hasn't been done in quite some time, so this is why we're recommending that you bleed and flush your brake fluid system. The next thing we're recommending that you consider doing is replacing your small auxiliary battery and also the trunk battery. The small battery, as you can see, has a date stamp on it. And the date stamp on the battery is 42/04. So this battery was manufactured the 42nd week of 2004. And this is why we're recommending that you change this battery, because the battery's already 6 years old, and these batteries generally last anywhere from 3 to 5 years with trouble-free maintenance, and after 5 years you're just taking your chances. So we recommend changing this small auxiliary battery, which is in the engine compartment. We are also recommending that you replace the trunk compartment battery. The trunk compartment battery appears to have not been replaced in a very long time. And you can see the date stamp is written right here on the terminal post. It's kind of blurry, I understand, but it's taped right on the battery. It says the 44th week of 2004. So that's what's stamped on the battery terminal post. And that's how we know how old this battery is. This is an AGM battery, and these batteries tend to be expensive, but I will email you an estimate for both the auxiliary battery and the main trunk battery. Okay, Mr. Ramos, we have the car up on the hoist, and we're looking at the left front suspension area, and you can see that right at this ball joint, right where the ball joint boot is touching the steering knuckle, the boot is starting to separate, and eventually what will happen is all the grease from this front control arm will come out and cause the front suspension control arm to squeak. So we recommend replacing the control arm for the left front suspension. And over here, when you follow the control arm with the light, you can see that the control arm bushing is starting to crack. So I don't know if you can see it, but this is cracking, and I'm just trying to make the light get a little bit better view on it, but you can see that the control arm itself, the bushing is all worn out and cracking. It's only a matter of time before this busts up and it's going to need to be replaced, but I recommend that you change both the left control arm, and it comes with the new bushing, and then also the right control arm bushing is also the same way. And you can see the bushing on the right control arm is also worn out and coming apart, and it's going to bust up in no time. So we recommend doing both the left and right sides, and we will email you an estimate for this. The next thing we're going to show you is that the transmission is starting to leak oil, and it's leaking from this transmission electric plug. The electric plug is located right there where the laser pointer is pointing at, and that electric plug is leaking oil and causing the transmission to lose oil. So we recommend replacing the transmission electric plug, and since we have to drop the pan, we might as well just go ahead and service the transmission at the same time. But you can see that the electric plug is leaking oil all over the bottom of the transmission pan, and we would like you to do this now so that you don't lose any more transmission oil and possibly damage your transmission by prolonging this any further. I will email you an estimate for this as well.